On their own, dipped in salsa or guacamole, or topped with chili and melted cheese, tortilla chips are the quintessential Mexican snack, even though they're actually an American invention. In the late 1940s, a Los Angeles tortilla factory began cutting and frying leftover tortillas, selling the first tortilla chips. When the chips are down, they usually go fast. Tortilla chips start out as raw yellow corn. The supplier cleans the kernels and dries them to a moisture content of 14%, then ships them to the chip factory. There, the corn goes into large, stainless steel cooking kettles filled with almost boiling water. Workers then add lime, an ingredient that does many things. It's antibacterial. It gives the corn a parched flavor. It helps loosen the husk, the kernel's shell, so it will come off later on. And lets moisture penetrate the kernel. Each kettle contains about 300 kilograms of corn and 90 kilos of water and lime combined. Next stop is a soak tank. The cooked corn sits there for 12 hours to further absorb water. Once the moisture content hits 45% and the husks are soft and loose, a pumping system moves the corn to the washer. This machine strains the water so that what's left is just soft, hydrated corn. The next stop is the tumbler, a rotating drum with perforated walls. Water jets blow off the loose husks. The corn travels on a conveyor from the tumbler to the mill. An auger feeds the corn into a stone grinder. It literally pulverizes the corn kernels between two stones, producing a soft corn dough called masa. The masa exits the mill through a narrow nozzle that shapes the dough into a thin sheet. The sheet then runs through rollers that have triangular dies on their surface. The triangles move into an oven heated to 340 degrees Celsius. They spend just 16 seconds inside, but that's enough time to dry the dough to the point where it won't break apart when handled. The heat also traps tiny pockets of moisture in the dough, creating little blisters. This gives the tortilla chips their trademark bumpy texture. From the oven, a conveyor belt transports the triangles to the fryer. The corn oil is 182 degrees Celsius. They take just 55 seconds to fry into chips. A mesh conveyor belt then lifts them out. As they leave, the excess oil drains back into the fryer. At the next stop, augers feed nacho flavor seasoning into a tumbler. The seasoning's main ingredients are powdered cheddar, parmesan, and Romano cheeses, and spices. Nozzles spray the chips with corn oil to make the surface adhesive. Then the seasoning tumbles on and sticks. After exiting the tumbler, the chips travel to the packing department. Chutes route them to different packaging machines. The packaging equipment represents technical choreography at its finest. Each machine has 14 bucket-shaped scales. When there's enough for one package, a trapdoor opens. The chips drop, just as a forming device shapes a piece of foil and plastic film into a bag. The chips land in the bag. Then a heat sealer immediately closes the top and cuts it free, while simultaneously sealing the bottom of the next bag. From bucket to bag to bowl, a tip-top chip shop performance.